This is the first time that the Mexican consulate, with the support of the foreign ministry and the government of state of Baja California, has organized the Mexico Advocacy Day, which we hope is going to become an annual tradition in the capital.
We were just finished talking about the losses caused by border waits and border times, and how critical it is that together we build the infrastructure that will allow both economies to recover, to allow us to build the kind of sustainable economies in our border region. It requires us to be cross-border. The study that Sandag did, that it costs us, wait times cost us, something on the order of the magnitude of 23 Super Bowls every year, because we don't have the ability to get the people back and forth across the border quickly. Those are the issues we focus on. We talked also in the hearing about cross-border emergency services, which we are all very conscious of due to the recent earthquake in Mexicali. That, again, was a bi-national event. I think California, because it's so long, some people live farther away and may not be as clear about it. Our economy is tied. And if we don't both grow together, if we don't solve some of these issues, like how do things get back and forth across the border, particularly goods movement, a lot of those goods are moving to other parts of California. They don't stay in San Diego. They come through San Diego, but they're going to Los Angeles to be shipped to China. They're going to San Francisco. They're going to Stockton. They're going to Sacramento. You have to remember, Mexico is our number one trading partner, and all Californians need to be worried about bottlenecks at the border, because it's stopping their businesses, their communities, places here in Sacramento who can't get their goods shipped or have delays. It can help the economy on both sides to be able to do some of these things together.